All right, we have a serious story that is unfolding this morning. In a bid to avoid conflict, the US president has spoken for over an hour with Russia's Vladimir Putin, while multiple countries, including Australia, are now strongly urging their citizens to evacuate Ukraine.
Yeah, CNN's senior national security correspondent Alex Marquardt joins us on the ground in central Ukraine. Alex, thank you for coming on our program. What's the feeling like right now there?
Well, I think you'd be quite surprised if you were listening to the White House and all the warnings that were coming from them and from other NATO countries that isn't really reflected in the mood here in Ukraine. There is no real sense of panic. You know, we've been driving across central and eastern Ukraine over the course of the past few days. You're not seeing massive military buildups. You're not seeing, you know, people going out and shopping and you know, buying all sorts of, you know, reserves for their homes. You know, I've been speaking with people in the streets. They say they're not very worried. It's not really something that they're thinking about. There really has been this, you know, dichotomy, if you will, between the people of Ukraine and the warnings that we've been hearing. And that really is, I'm told, because Ukraine was invaded 8 years ago and the peninsula of Crimea was annexed. So this is kind of a threat that they have been facing for a very long time. They believe that an invasion by Russia could have happened at any point in the last 8 years. So for the U.S. and others to come along and now say, well, this is imminent, you know, they're saying, well, this is something that we're used to. And so the message that we're hearing from the top on down, from President Zelensky, his ministers and various other officials is, you know, don't panic, that we don't want to cause chaos, but we are also ready if something should happen. You know, the Ukrainian military has really built itself up over the course of the past 8 years. They are much stronger than they were before. And they have had all this equipment and weapons that have been sent to them by Western countries in order to defend themselves. So they're in a very different place that they were 8 years ago. So there is a bit of difference between Ukrainian officials. They are not convinced as NATO countries are. But for the moment, things are calm. That, of course, could change the very moment that Russia crosses the border.
Yes, and Ukraine asking for the rest of the world not to panic, but how has this phone call between the two leaders helped to quell fears of an attack?
It has not. No real breakthroughs were made on that call, as far as we understand it. And President Putin also spoke with the French President Emmanuel Macron, with whom he does have a closer relationship than most other world leaders. It sounds like everyone's saying the right things and that they want these diplomatic conversations to continue. They want to give diplomacy a chance. You know, Russia insisting that they don't plan on invading Ukraine, but at the same time, Russia continuing to complain that their needs are not being met. You know, Russia is trying to play the victim here, saying that it's NATO that is creeping closer to them. It's their security that's being threatened. So, you know, it's always good when world leaders are talking. It usually means that the guns are not firing. But at the same time, it does not sound like any real breakthroughs have been made. And we heard from the White House that their calculus has not changed. And the White House is saying that, you know, there is intelligence to suggest that Russia could launch an invasion of Ukraine before the end of the Olympics, and that is next weekend, February 20th.
And what does that mean for you and your colleagues, Alex, people, media teams that are reporting from Ukraine? Are you feeling like you're going to have to leave there, be ordered to evacuate soon?
That is a very good question, and it's something that we're reassessing every single day. Every news outlet, newspaper, TV station is taking it individually, obviously taking it extremely seriously. We have a number of countries, including the U.S. and the U.K., that have called on their citizens to leave. And, you know, again, we are going to be taking this day by day. Right now, there's no war. And obviously, we have very experienced teams. We have very experienced security. And so the discussions are not just amongst ourselves, but with other news organizations. And we are going to take, obviously, the utmost precautions in a way that we can continue to cover this extremely important story.
Well, it has been really interesting to hear from you this morning, CNN senior national security correspondent Alex Marquardt. Thank you for joining us.